Zara's in the streets. It is for everyone. Hey loves, it's your very blind chick back on your screen with another one. I don't know about you, but I'm obsessed with online shopping. It's so much easier to shop online when you're legally blind. So in today's video, I'm gonna share with you my tips, tricks, and tidbits so that the next time you order something, you don't get surprised when your package arrives. There's nothing worse than ordering something, being super hype about it, and then being disappointed when you have it in your hands. So I hope these hacks I have will help not just the blind fam, but the sight squad too, so the next time you order something, you are completely satisfied. Let's jump right in with JLUX Label. This is the newest addition to my addiction. I started using this app a couple of weeks ago, and you know it's crazy when you have an app for that. But this company has my name all over it. It's an Insta baddie type of boutique, so you're gonna get all types of basics that bang and clothes that just hit. It's just every outfit, it just looks so good. There's never been something that I ordered that didn't look good on my silhouette. When I first started shopping here, I was very concerned because it only comes in 3 sizes and I'm a skinny mini, but it fits me perfectly. I'll put my dimensions down below in case you're interested to reference. My first tip when it comes to stores like these is to take the time to zoom in. Especially if you're visually impaired, you wanna know what you're buying. But even if you're part of the sight squad and can see perfectly, you wanna know what the details are. Where does this hit? Where does it cinch? Does it have an asymmetrical seam? Is there stitching and lining there? I cannot tell you how many times I've ordered something and then been surprised because there's detailing or design that I didn't even know. But had I just taken the time to zoom in, I would have realized. While we're still on the site, another tip I have is to go to the product description and look at the material composition. This takes literally 10 seconds and can change the game. Here you'll find, what is this made of? How is this gonna sit on your silhouette? How is this gonna fit and feel on your body? Is it gonna be thick? Is it gonna be not thick enough? Is it gonna stretch? Is it stiff? Is it gonna smell when it sweats? All your answers are here. And if you wanna take it to the next level, do the most like me, go into your closet. There's always something to compare. Just zoom in with your phone if you need to and look at the left side where the tag is and you'll see, oh, this is slinky, or maybe it's gonna be more sheer like this. Anytime I've ever done that, I've gotten a better idea of what the fabric feels like. Enough about JLUX Label. Zara. Zara and I go way back. This is how I paid for my tuition when I was in school. And also, truth be told, I wouldn't have my sense of style had it not been for this store. Working there, I really learned how to pair things and how to make trends less trendy. Personally, I prefer the classic vibe with sometimes a little bit of flair. They do a lot. Sometimes I feel like they go over the edge and over the ledge with their styles, but for the most part, there's something for everyone. I'm telling you, Zara's in the streets. It is for everyone. My suggestion and recommendation when it comes to sites that seem to have everything, they're a one-stop shop, they have your loungewear, your workwear, your weekend wear, is to, instead of scrolling the new and find yourself scrolling like you're on the gram, to go into the categories or the collection and pick something that you're interested in. Or maybe you're in the market and have an intention to get, say, jumpsuits. So you'll click that section and you'll scroll down. And once you find something that's appealing, use the time you would have used looking through all the other stuff that you might not have wanted to go through all the way to the bottom where they have the flat lay. This is the picture of the model not wearing it, which I think is always an easier way to get an idea of how the clothes is gonna fit. Sometimes with these high fashion European style stores, they look like The Exorcist the way they're posing. And can't really tell the designs or the details which make or break the fit. So just scroll down, get rid of all the noise. Sometimes even the face of the model, because they're making faces I can't. I just have to go all the way down to where there's no distraction and see the garment as it is. The next three I don't have apps for, but it's probably for my own financial safety. Naked Wardrobe is another new addition. I've been shopping here for maybe 2 months. It takes about that long for something to come, so I wouldn't say it's highly recommended, but everything that's come has been snatched. They even have a line called Snatch, and they're not playing when they called it that. It has you cinched in, sucked up, giving you that body, yaddy, 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 yaddy. And that says a lot, because I'm shaped like a telephone pole, cereal box, whatever you want to call it, and I still got them curves when I put on the Naked Wardrobe. So that lets you know. Sometimes this site freezes and I don't know why. Tip for sites like these is to look at the model dimensions. A lot of times I can't picture myself in clothes like these. I might be a wallflower some days and not want to have my body out there like that, but on days when I want to really accentuate what I've been working out on, I want to make sure that it's going to actually fit right. And much like with JLUX Label, because you're not sure about the sizing, it's a good idea to look at the model dimension where it says Ashley is 5'11 and 178 pounds wearing a size small. That way you can get an idea, maybe I should do the extra small, or maybe I'm a small too, or maybe I'm a medium or a large. And every time I've done that, I've had a better time picking the right size for me, even between different stuff on the same site. From form-fitting to feminine, floaty, and floral sabo skirt, this is where I love to shop for the summer season. It's a resort vacation vibe. I'm telling you, anytime I wear a dress from here, I get a where did you get that from? Every piece I've ever picked has been impeccable quality. My tip when it comes to sites like these, anywhere you're shopping overseas, is to take the time to ask questions. Hit that chat box, send them an email. This stuff is not cheap, let me tell you. So why not make sure that you're buying what you think you're buying? My perfect example is last year I wanted to buy a pair of sandals and I was like, am I a 7 or an 8? Because in real life I'm a 7.5, but they don't have that. So I asked them and they said 8. I would have bought a 7 because I always like to go down a size, but thank God I got an 8 because a 7 would have definitely had my toes over the ledge like a gargoyle. So with that said, just take the time. And also when you build that rapport with the company, you get an idea if things go wrong, how long is it going to take for them to respond. If I had to choose just one of these five, this would be my favorite. It's Meshki. This is my everything. They got the best jogger sets, lounge sets, knit sets, swim sets, all types of sets. And I'm here for it. Every time I go on this site, there's something for me. I swear, it's problematic to the point where I've deleted the newsletter a million times because it is way too tempting. My recommendation when it comes to sites like these, because the exchange rate can kind of kill you, especially if you're Canadian like me, is to look for coupon and promo codes. When it comes to these kind of insta boutique type of places, they've always got a promo code, or they're usually working with your favorite influencer who happens to do a haul that has a discount. Hey, if you want to haul at a girl, I'm right here. And with that, you can use that 10, 15, sometimes even 20 or 30% to save you the money it would cost to either ship the product or the duties. Knock on wood, I haven't been charged that much for duties, but when it hits hard. So to avoid that, or at least balance out the scale, get that price point down by putting in those promo codes. That's that on that. That wraps up this video. I hope that you enjoyed it. Let me know what your favorite tip is down below. If you haven't already, subscribe. And until next time, stay safe, stay sane, stay blessed. Oh, if you want to see another version before I wrap up, definitely let a girl know, because I would do one on athleisure and home decor, but I want to know which one you guys are interested in. So let a girl know. And until next time, love and later.